Hi all, and welcome to Occult Melbourne Part 4. So we'll just have a look over the St. Patrick's Cathedral here with its cross-like floor plan, its three phallic steeples and so forth. This is a model that is within the St. Patrick's Cathedral itself. Here we are looking down on the cathedral. So here it is here. There is another little cathedral here with a similar orientation. Over here is the State Parliament of Victoria that we've already had a look at. Here towards the east, this side being the east where the sun rises, this side being the west where the sun sets, north, south. Here to the east of the cathedral is this round shape that is perhaps representative of the sun. Churches and cathedrals can be positioned towards the east, so the people within the church pray towards the east, where perhaps the Saviour comes from, or where the sun rises. So moving on, I've just put some markers through there showing that orientation. We'll just keep going, I just thought it was an interesting thing to do. Here we have the path of the sun over the region of Melbourne. This would represent the path of the sun. It rises pretty much exactly in the east and sets in the west there. So this is the equinoxes, equiday, equinight, your winter solstice up here, and your summer solstice with the longest path down here. I just superimposed that over the churches, but there's no real alignment there that I can see. So we were looking at cathedrals. So the word cathode is very similar to cathedral, and I'm often referring to electricity as per the god El, electricity, and magnetism as per Mary Magdalene. So let's have a look at the etymology of the word cathode. So Greek here, kathodos, descent, way down. Just further down here, we can see that the current traverses the cathode from the east to the west, so to speak, as per the sun traveling from the east to the west. And we have the reference here to the direction the sun appears to move and set and so on. So we'll just keep moving on. Just some quick pictures of how and reminders of how churches and temples can be set up similar to that of the human body. Some more pictures here we'll just quickly go through. There's the Chartres Cathedral that is very similar in design to the St. Patrick's Cathedral, that one's in France. So here we are within the Chartres Cathedral. This region of the cathedral is the is what is known as the nave. So within here we have a labyrinth. Now perhaps this labyrinth comes from the labia of the vagina, where you have your inner labia minora and your outer labia majora. So, and it's in the nave where the belly button is, the navel. Officially, churches this nave region is officially called the nave because it perhaps represents a boat, an upturned boat, but. Anyway, I tend to think that things are perhaps a little different to that in reality. So I'm suggesting that this is basically an umbilical cord, and I'm sure you can work out what I'm trying to say there. So we'll just carry on. I want to get through some stuff here. This is the drawing that I've shown before, just highlighting what is perhaps the testicles and penis as described by Jordan Maxwell, who has pointed this out. And then this sort of more pinkish region out here perhaps represents the walls of the vagina. Carrying on further, we'll just have a quick look at some of the zodiacal references on the Chartres Cathedral windows. And okay, so here we are outside the Melbourne St. Patrick's Cathedral. We have the St. George's Cross and the St. Andrew's Cross, and we have this bird or phoenix or eagle perhaps flying through a gateway, if you will, out the front here. We'll keep moving on. a bit of a pan of the courtyard there. And so there we have the phallic steeples. There's a bit of water coming down, a bit of rain, good old Melbourne weather. And up here we have what is known as a triregnum with three crowns. Here we have one with four crowns. I just thought I'd point that out. We have keys, which are often represented as silver and gold. Perhaps the gold represents the a gateway for the gods, and one the silver a gateway for the men. But perhaps these keys in reality open up the mind, open up areas of the mind, the brain. So here we have the aisles. This would be the penile section here, and perhaps the inner part here of the vagina. We'll just have a look at the ceiling, which perhaps represents the inner walls of the vagina, or the womb of creation, if you will, which I'm suggesting. I'm not saying these are facts. These are things that I'm suggesting, and you can think about them for yourselves. There's a painting on the wall here. We have a picture on the wall. We have Leo, and then across the other side we have Taurus. Here we see the bull and the sun and Taurus on the logo there. We'll keep moving along. I have to get through quite a bit here. So there's just a reference there with Leo and Taurus. Moving along. Here we are in the aisle. The detail in the woodwork here on the pews or the chairs, we can see what is perhaps a reference to the vagina there, coming out of that fleur-de-lis type shape. Over here we have what is perhaps the sun on the cross on the equinoxes and solstices. Once again, within this church. Now we're now on the outside of the church, and we'll just look up to a gargoyle. So a gargoyle is named a gargoyle because the water sort of flows through the mouth, and you can see the water flow through the mouth there. So this is of Premier Jeff Kennett. Premier Jeff Kennett has been accused of various things. I don't have any proof of those things, and I don't believe that he has been convicted of them, but and some of them even relate to perhaps what you might expect a Catholic priest to get in trouble for. Interestingly, Jeff Kennett is not even a Catholic, and this is a Catholic church, so it's quite bizarre. Anyway, you can research these things further for yourself. We'll just keep moving on. Over the other side here, we have a gargoyle that is perhaps a lion. The a lion there. The labial doorway there. The labial doorway of the vaginal-esque doorway of the church. Just another quick look there at that gargoyle. The circle, the circle on the cross, perhaps the sun on the cross once again. Spires and steeples. And here we have St. Catherine of Siena. We'll just have a closer look here at this statue. Here she is holding up a crown of thorns. The crown of thorns perhaps relate to the rays of the sun, to the corona. As we can see here, the Latin root of the word corona means crown. With your heart here, you have the coronary artery that supplies the myocardium, that is the heart muscle, with blood. And the arterioles that come off that supply the heart. These perhaps look like the thorns as well, the thorns coming off here. Over here we have the corona beer with the sun. What is perhaps the corona around here? We have the crown reference up here. This is a photo of an eclipse, and we can see a sort of a plasma discharge, the corona of the sun here, the outer portion. Here is a close-up of the sun's surface, and we can see some magnetic activity coming off the sun, off that electrical sun, perhaps. So we'll just keep moving along. Here we're going to have a close-up of that crown of thorns. Okay, so we've come to the end of part 4. I'll see you in part 5.